I wondered if the competition was close enough to bring the best out of him.
Well, sir, I think it was pretty close today. I thought some of the others were going to come through on the second run, but fortunately my first run stood up. But yeah, that was close. No, I think, you know, the competition's there in the big events. I can't afford to make any mistakes. And, you know, the moment that I do become complacent, I'm just going to start, you know, coming second, third, and even worse. So, you know, I've really got to keep thinking ahead.
At 27, Paul McConkie is the oldest man in this heat. Paul's a sheet metal worker in Wolverhampton and was also a member of our World Championships gold medal team. Paul had a mishap in practice, splitting the hull of his boat completely, and he had to tape up that damage before coming out to compete in the real thing. Now, that accident happened between gates 5 and 6 at the point of the course, known as the Pot. We'll see him approaching gates 5 and 6.
But worse is still to come, perhaps. The Grand Prix run awaits. Downstream, through the millfall. Probably the fastest part of the course. And the roughest as well, I would think.
And he did it in one complete move there, which is the first competitor, I think, today to do it that way.
Yes, taking gate 10. Bow on. And his time is looking gloriously. Must be aware that it's on.
He's failed his roll.
Gate 13 was not numbered without some irony, I think.
Well, despite his problems at gate 13, where he had 10 seconds added, Paul McConkie has made it to the final with a time of 2 minutes 53.1. If I made you feel I'm so sorry I was blind. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
At the top of the course, starting our first run, Liz Sharman for Great Britain. Bib number 70, a world champion in 1983, only the fifth 2 years ago, but very determined to regain her title. Watch the bow, up it goes as she leans back. That's the pancake move as she goes through gate number 7, another upstream gate, very efficiently into the current there, going on down to gates 8 and 9. Liz, meanwhile, in this tricky combination, through 12 nicely, and 13. Now look at that kayak, it never stops moving, powers on all the time. Real concentration from Liz Sharman there, total harmony with the water. Underneath the road bridge, and well on her way down, into gate number 20. see how tight she is to that pole, not losing any time at all. Another downstream gate, the green and white poles there. Now really putting the power on. You'll see the change of direction for 22. She passes that rock horizontally, set across the course, nicely through there. Now, and this looks to be a fast time, and it is 3:36.64. Clearly into the lead ahead of the West German, and she's got no penalties face. But today belongs to Liz Sharman, champion for a second time around.
Feels great. Feels better than it did the first time.
This man is the new world champion. He won't know it, but he's the last competitor. Melvin Jones was the only man who could have beaten him, but he's had to settle for bronze. So the four times world champion is now five times world champion. It doesn't matter what he does on this run, he's already got a 5 second penalty. It's his first run that will count. One of Britain's great sporting ambassadors. He's won a gold in the team event. His wife is the women's world champion, and Richard Fox is the world champion for the fifth time. A marvelous result for British canoeing. An astonishing fifth world title for Fox, and but for Richard Weiss taking the silver, it would have been a clean sweep with Jones and Pierce third and fourth.
When I heard the river had come up, you know, I just smiled, I laughed, I thought, that's it, you know, it's for me today. Listen, all you people, come gather round.